Hello everybody, my name is Zohir Chaudhary. Today's topic is about melting of the ice. So let's quickly learn about the various components of ice. These components of ice together, they're known as the cryosphere, just like the biosphere, lithosphere. We also have the cryosphere. Cryosphere is that components around the globe that is made up of ice. They make up snow, river and lake ice, sea ice, glaciers and ice caps, ice shelves, ice sheets, frozen grounds, essentially anything that deals with ice, it's within the cryosphere. So let's quickly look at this figure and see where these components are so you can put a mental picture with each of the components. You all know about glaciers, which covers typically in the mountain and it stays frozen year-round. These are known as ice caps because they are on top of mountains. These are huge ice sheets that have accumulated over many, many years. And this tiny little thing that is floating on the ocean but is attached to the ice sheet is known as a shelf, ice shelf, just like a shelf to place books. This is a floating piece of ice that is attached to the sheet, but it's like a shelf. And then you have broken pieces of ice that could be icebergs, but if this ice is actually on top of the ocean and covers the ocean, that is known as sea ice, ice over the sea. The ground when it's frozen, it's known as the frozen ground, of course, and these are typically moisture in the ground that with winter time becomes frozen, so your soil gets hard, it gets hardened. The definitions here continues, and you can of course read them on by yourself. So the glaciers is a large, slow-moving river of ice formed from compacted layers of snow that slowly deforms and flows in response to gravity and high pressure. So the point to remember in here is that a glacier is typically in the mountain and gravity slowly pushes it down. So a glacier actually moves with time because gravity keeps on pushing it. Sea ice, as I mentioned earlier, is all of that ice that is formed on top of the sea, and you can typically find it in the Arctic Ocean and over Antarctica near the ocean area. Iceberg, let's not confuse it with sea ice, even though they may be very similar. It is ice that floats on the ocean. Most of this iceberg, it's actually down into the water. Only a little bit, it's visible on the top. Ice shelf, it's a thick platform of ice that floats on the ocean, and it can be attached to ice sheets or also glaciers where it meets the ocean. And it's typically found in Antarctica, Greenland, and Canada. So sea ice, which is the ice over the ocean, we have been measuring it since 1979 or so with the help of satellite images. So the two satellite images in here from 1979 and 2007, you can see that it shows a striking difference between sea ice. Ice is covered on the Arctic in here over the ocean, and you can see we see a lot of ice over here, but by 2007 almost 30 to 40% has melted. And the data in here also, it's extent in million of square kilometers of the sea ice surface area, and you can see that you see a progressive decline of sea ice over time, leading to more or less present time, and this trend is actually increasing. I highly recommend that you watch this slideshow, which is also available on the Blackboard. On Blackboard, and you can follow along the time span of how ice has been shrinking. So the Arctic sea ice is thinning, and you can see it in here that because of the surface melting, it's slowly thinning and thinning and thinning. And as a result, animals such as polar bear that depends on this location, they have less and less area to hunt and survive. So they become endangered. Let's do a quick concept check. Melting of sea ice leads to sea level rise. True or false? the melting of sea ice does not lead to sea level rise. I know it's difficult to understand, but think about it. This ice is actually floating on the ocean. So as all of this ice chunk melts, what would happen? It would not cause sea level rise because the sea ice, the volume of this ice, it's already accounted for into the ocean. Imagine a glass of water. If you like, imagine an empty glass. Imagine an empty glass. You fill it up with ice cubes, then you pour some water. What would happen? The ice cubes would have already accounted that volume within that glass. So, as the ice melts inside that glass, even after all of that ice cube melts, it would not start overflowing. You would not have a rise of water in your glass. So, sea ice is just like that. Floating pieces of ice or big chunk of ice that once it melts, it doesn't lead to sea level rise. However, it does lead to other climate consequences. On the other hand, the ice over Greenland, with this is ice located on the land, it's not the same story. As this ice melts, which has been melting over time, the water would go in the ocean. So what would happen once the water goes into the ocean? Water that was located over land, now it is in the ocean, so it would start rising. So ice over Greenland leads to sea level rise, but ice on the sea does not, once it melts, it does not lead to sea level rise. So the ice over Greenland has also been melting. 1992's extent of melt area, 2002 extent of melt area, further from the inland. By 2005, we're seeing more and more inland areas to start melting. And here you can see a trend line of the extent of ice and how it has been increasing more and more over Greenland. This is not a slideshow, this is actually a video, can get you a glimpse of what is happening in this location. And this video can also be accessed through Blackboard. In 2012, something very strange happened over Greenland. Pretty much the summer of 2012, and the dates were from July 8 to July 12, a heat wave came into Greenland and the entire surface started melting. Again, mind you that Greenland has almost 3 miles of ice, so the surface, it's probably like maybe the first 50 centimeter or less. We have been seeing some melting of the first few centimeter for the first time in visual history. This is dangerous because more and more of the surface has started melting. It causes destabilization of these ice sheets, and the water can percolate down and essentially destabilize and fall into the ocean, leading to massive sea level rise once a big chunk of ice sheets from Greenland starts destabilizing and falling into the ocean. So, quick concept check: melting of ice on Greenland leads to sea level rise. True or false? True. The reason is because the ice is on the land, not on the ocean. So when this melts, it does lead to sea level rise. Thank you for listening, and until next time.